Hello, Oracles. Oracle Tim here from Oracle Investments. Today is going to be super exciting. Today I'm going to share with you my projections for the production of the Tesla vehicles in 2022. I'm going to break it down by quarter, by factory, and I'll even break it down by vehicle and what I think each vehicle is going to be produced for the course of the year. Now, to get started, I had to struggle to be conservative with my numbers. I was looking at things. I was like, wow, these numbers seem to be completely off the charts bullish. And could that be possible? Yes, but I wanted to be realistic, be conservative. I work in construction retail. We have already gotten another wave of price increases from all of our vendors. Many of our vendors are 4 to 6 months in lead time for product when it's usually a week or less. So we are still looking at extended lead times for my profession. I have no doubt that is true for the rest of the world and every other industry. We know that Tesla is way ahead of the game. Tesla is very smart. They have planned for a lot of stuff, but for 2 years worth of supply chain issues, even Elon has said that, you know, supply chain issues are a struggle. I mean, heck, my Model Y just got pushed from October to November of next year. I'm sure that once Austin comes on board, that will get pulled back closer to maybe summertime, but still, we're already getting Model Ys pushed out longer and longer lead times for people who already have reservations. So with that said, I pulled my numbers back a little bit, but even my base case is pretty awesome, so I'm gonna get into sharing this all with you now. And now, to be completely transparent, I actually used most of the numbers that Elon or someone at Tesla has mentioned themselves as what their projections can be for the end of 2022. And I even took those and reeled them back a little bit. And a couple other factors that I worked into this were, you know, needing to ramp the 4680 batteries. That is a huge component of this. If Tesla can successfully ramp 4680 batteries, that will increase production as well. I also took every month and pulled back 2 to 3 days per month of production based on holiday downtime. Who knows what's gonna happen with COVID. They've gotta retool their machinery also. So I took that out and factored that all in. So my numbers, I think, for my base case are very conservative. And in this video, I'll break down my base case, which is 1.855 million vehicles produced. My bear case is around 1.4 to 1.5. Assuming there's major issues that go on, Berlin gets delayed even more, huge problems. And then my bull case, which is the whole premise of this video because I think it is totally possible, is 2.1 million vehicles produced in 2022. So Elon has said that Fremont can produce 50% more than they currently are. They're just over 400,000 produced last year. So I am looking at just under 600,000 vehicles produced for Fremont for 2022. Broken down by quarter as they continue ramping up, there'll be about 109,000 vehicles for Q1, about 127,000 for Q2, 138,000 for Q3, 166,000 for Q4 for a total of 541,000 vehicles for the year out of Fremont. Next is Shanghai. And Shanghai, I know that they have their expansion coming. I was actually extremely conservative with my Shanghai numbers, and I didn't even take the expansion into account. I just went based off of where they're currently projected going and even pulled that number back a little bit. So this is kind of a conservative number here. So I've got Q1 at about 171,000 vehicles, Q2 at 185,000 vehicles, Q3 at 200,000, and Q4 at 217,000. I know full well that they had talked about how by March, they should be hitting a ramp rate of around 1 million vehicles produced. So I took that into account, took some of those numbers, played them out, then took out some time frames that they might be downtime because they do have their holidays. And again, the supply chain issues that I took into account. So I reeled it back and it looks like for me, 775,000 vehicles produced for Shanghai next year. And now for the first half of 2022, I have Austin and Berlin numbers based the same. Tesla has said that their goal was between 200,000 and 300,000 vehicles by the end of the year for 2022. So I roughly put them at about 250,000 vehicles each. That is a run rate of about 5,000 to 10,000 vehicles per week that Tesla had estimated. And so for Q1 and Q2, I have them both the same. I have 30,000 vehicles produced for Q1, 65,000 vehicles produced for Q2. Q3 is where it changes strictly because I think that Q3 is when the Cybertruck is going to start getting produced out of Austin. And so Austin's Q3 number is just under 82,000, and Q4 is 107,000 for a total of 284,000 vehicles out of Austin in 2022. And Berlin's second half numbers are 76,000 in Q3 and 83,000 in Q4 for a total of 254,000 vehicles produced in 2022. And so when you put this all together, we are looking at, based on my projections, 1.85 million vehicles produced in 2022 by Tesla. Again, this is a very, in my opinion, conservative number, but it's based on a lot of macro environment factors that are going to be out of Tesla's control. Again, if Tesla can navigate the macro environment challenges with the supply chain issues, and if they can get the 4680 ramped, I think they can definitely get up to the 2.1 million vehicle produced bull case that I have set. And quite honestly, getting another 115,000 vehicles produced out of Shanghai alone in 2022, I think is extremely doable. Again, I was really conservative there, didn't even take into account the expansion that they're putting on there. So 2 million seems very, very doable, assuming the supply chain issues do not cause them major problems. And now getting into full vehicle breakdown, we are looking at the S and the X. I've got them slated for 37,500 vehicles each. Tesla has said that they would like to get back to a 100,000 vehicle per year run rate for these vehicles. I've got those two together at 75,000. And now the ramp rates for a lot of these vehicles, I don't know if you have noticed, but the Model Y has started to overtake the Model 3 as far as production goes. You know, Elon has said that by 2023, the Model Y will be the best-selling vehicle in the world. And in order to do that, they need to produce more of them. So that's why the ramp rates have changed. And so out of Fremont, I see 233 Model 3s. And out of Shanghai, I see 310,000 Model 3s. And I realize that the Model 3 growth that I have for Shanghai is very minimal. That is strictly because of the fact that with supply chain issues, I feel that Tesla would opt for putting those supplies into Model Ys rather than Model 3s in order to produce more Model Ys. So the Model 3, not to say it's going to take a back burner, but it's going to just be not as important as the Model Y in 2022. So that's for a total of 540,000 Model 3s worldwide next year. And now onto the Model Y. So the Model Y, again, if you split Fremont 50-50 between the Model 3 and the Model Y, Fremont's going to produce 233,000 Model Ys also. The difference in Shanghai is the expansion that they're putting on is going to most likely be heavily Y-based. So that there is going to be 465,000 Model Ys. And Austin and Berlin are both starting with just the Model Y. So the entire production there, 250,000 vehicles of Model Y coming out of each one of those factories, puts us at 1.2 million Model Ys produced in 2022. Keep in mind that the number one selling vehicle in the world is the Toyota Corolla, and that sold 1.1 million vehicles in 2020. So 1.2 million produced of the Model Y in 2022 will set it up perfectly to become the best-selling vehicle in the world in 2023. And then we've got the Austin bonus of the Cybertruck. I am guessing a Q3 production ramp start for the Cybertruck. I'm guessing and I'm hopeful that we're going to get about 30,000 Cybertrucks pushed out in 2022, all in the second half. That's a hopeful guess. Don't know. We're going to know more at the roadmap, most likely. But that is my prediction, and 30,000 coming out of Austin of the Cybertruck. Now, I know that the Semi is in very limited production right now. It's going to be such a small number of vehicles. I didn't even include them in my predictions because I honestly don't know what the ramp is going to be on them. the 4680s are the integral part of the Semi, and they need to get the 4680s ramped in order to get the Model Y and the Cybertruck going, because those are going to take precedence over the Semi. So I didn't factor those in. I don't even, you know, maybe a couple of thousand. It was so minute that it's not going to make my numbers change in any great form. And now, one of the things that both Zach Kirkhorn and Elon had mentioned about ramping factories is the cost burden. And it usually drags down margins, because when you're ramping up a new factory, things come up. You've got extra costs that are, you know, out of your control that you didn't foresee. But keep in mind, with 1.2 million Model Ys being produced, out of Shanghai, their margins are 29%. The goal for Austin and Berlin is to be the same. So if you're looking at almost 30% margin for 1.2 million vehicles, and then for 75,000 Model S and X with a much higher margin, and if we get 30,000 Cybertrucks with a higher margin, the majority, significant majority, of the vehicles that Teslas are producing are going to be over 30%. So anytime you hear a bear saying that they're going to take, you know, the margins are going to come down, dude, their margins are going to be insane this year. I'm really looking forward to see what their margins can do with all of these factories ramping up. And then once the factories are ramped by the end of 2022 and we hit 2023, guess what? Those ramp costs are gone. Let me know in the comments below what your production forecast is for 2022. Let me know if you've got a bear, bull, base case. Let me see how close you are to my estimates. And let me know if you think that I'm completely way off, because I am totally open to suggestions, but I think that I am relatively conservative with my base case. Thank you guys all so much for watching. You guys are all awesome. Best support ever. If you have not subscribed, please do so down below. I will see you guys all later. Have a great one.